In this video, we'll discuss profit maximization as an objective for businesses. After you're done watching this video, you should understand why profit maximization has traditionally been viewed as the main objective of a firm and how it is achieved. If you have any questions, leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. Profit is the reward for the risks taken by the entrepreneur in organizing the factors of production. Thus, they would aim to maximize that reward. The assumption in economics is that individuals aim to maximize their utility and that firms aim to maximize profit. For firms, this is achieved by maximizing the difference between total revenue and total costs. Profit maximization is a model of understanding a firm's behavior. In reality, firms also pursue other objectives. These will be discussed in future videos. To understand it further, I'll revisit two key marginal concepts: marginal revenue and marginal cost. The firm is going to continue to produce more units as long as marginal revenue exceeds marginal cost. If the additional revenue earned from the sale of a good exceeds the additional cost of producing that good, then a positive contribution is being made towards profit. The profit maximizing level of output is Q star. The reason for this is that each prior unit is contributing to overall profit as marginal revenue is greater than marginal cost. The firm will continue to produce until no further profit can be achieved from production. This occurs where marginal revenue equals marginal cost. At this point, Q star, profit is maximized. Beyond this point, marginal cost exceeds marginal revenue. Further production is now reducing profits as costs exceed revenues gained in production. Classical economics suggests that firms are traditionally profit maximizers. In reality, there are some challenges and difficulties with that view. First, it is easy to identify this point in a simple diagram, but much more complicated for firms to accurately measure their marginal revenue and marginal costs. They may try to get close to this point, but it is difficult to be precise. Secondly, high levels of profit in some industries can attract government regulation and oversight. Firms may be more likely to pursue other objectives as opposed to solely focusing on maximizing profit. These might include a short-run sacrifice of profit in order to maximize profits in the long run. In the coming videos, we'll take a look at some of these alternative objectives and the reasons why firms would pursue them. That wraps up this video on profit maximization. We'll look at other possible objectives of firms in the next few days and aim to develop your understanding of the behavior of firms. Leave any questions or comments below, and I'll see you in the next one.